Good morning, Lu Wen. Today we're going to learn a very simple lesson. But it is a most important lesson. Why must I worship in the Church of Christ? Because we study this because in the afternoon our brothers are learning to preach. And one young person is studying this topic. So I realized that I haven't spoken about this topic for a while. On one hand, it could be an example for them to follow. Why must I worship God in the Church of Christ? Number one, the name of the church. Jesus said, I will build my church. Jesus said, my church. So naturally, other people should call this church the Church of Christ.
Church of Jesus.
Church of Jesus.
Okay.
So this is simple logic. Now, why would we call it the Church of Christ? It should be called Church of Jesus. Because Jesus said, I want to establish my church. So if it's my church, so it should be the Church of Jesus. But Jesus wants us to believe that He's the Christ. If you don't believe that He is the Christ, then you will die in your sins. Therefore, we call this church the Church of Christ. Now, I'm going to clearly explain this to the world. Jesus said, I want to establish my church. According to normal logic, it should be called the Church of Jesus. But Jesus wanted us to believe that He is the Christ. If we don't believe that He is Christ, then we will die in our sins. So in order for us to receive salvation, we must believe that Jesus is the Christ. So that's why we call this the Church of Christ. So Apostle Paul reconfirmed this for us. To be called the Church of Christ. This is found in Romans chapter 16:16. 1,500 years ago, all churches were the Church of Christ. And this is the history that everyone knows and understands. So in Revelations, there's in chapter 2 and 3, there's 7 churches. They don't have the name Church of Christ. Because they are all churches of Christ. So they don't need to say this name. They just call it by the location of where the church exists, such as Ephesus. Because everyone knows these are churches of Christ. But when it comes to America and New York, that's not good enough. You can't say church. You must say Church of Christ. Or some other church. But according to the Bible, you must be the Church of Christ. Because Jesus said He wants to establish His church. And He said you must believe that He is the Christ. If you want to be saved and not die in your sins, then you must be in the Church of Christ. Because you must believe that Jesus is the Christ. So Jesus added to the saved people to the church. Now at 10 o'clock we have Chinese people. So I explained it to them. Because in the Chinese Bible, you can't find this translation. So in the English translation, you'll find one book or one translation that has this translation. So this piece of information, piece of knowledge, is not easy to gain. When it comes to finding money, when it comes to New York, they can find it in any hole or crack in the wall. They'll find it.
Good job.
Good translation.
Okay.
So the Lord adds the saved people to the church.
So
2,000 years ago, there was only one church, so naturally we call this church the Church of Christ. So naturally, we call this church the Church of Christ. But if you just study the Chinese Bible, then you have problems. Because they don't have this meaning. So the church is to be a virgin wife to Christ, the one husband.
Virgin wife to the one husband, Christ, okay? So
this church is to be the virgin wife to Christ, the one husband. So when a virgin girl is married to a husband, she is called wife of the husband's name. So sometimes I joke around and I say, if you don't like to be called wife of a cow, then don't marry someone with the last name
with cow.
A lot of Chinese people, their last name is Ngao, which means sounds like cow. Because after you get married to this person with the last name Cow, you'll be Mrs. Cow. So this way of addressing the wife is natural, normal, and legal. You are so-and-so's wife, so after you are married to him, the way people address you is by saying Mrs. So-and-so. So after the marriage ceremony is over, the officiator of the wedding will definitely talk about this. So this is the official announcement of so-and-so, Mr. and Mrs. So-and-so. And it is using the man's last name. So after you are married, naturally you have this way of addressing that person. So according to what I know, after marriage, people don't sit down and ponder upon, oh, what should my last name be after marriage? Naturally, it should be Mr. and Mrs. So-and-so. So to call a married woman Mrs. other than the name of her husband's last name is a hint of adultery. And this is very serious and very dangerous. And us Chinese people, we don't play this game. Because this is a very serious matter for Chinese people. We won't call one person's wife another person's wife's last name. Because this is a big insult. It insults the husband, it insults the wife. It's a very serious matter.
所以我希望全世界所有教会
So I hope that all churches, if you have any other name, that you should seriously consider this matter. It's a very serious matter. So if any man or any husband hears someone call his wife by another last name, someone will be killed. So it's a very serious matter. Because it hints on adultery. So that's why we don't do these things. So you have to be careful. If your church has any other name, in the spiritual sense, it's adultery. This is written in Revelation chapter 17. Now I'll remind everyone again, if your church has any other name, then you have to be careful. Don't think you can be saved. Because you insult Jesus Christ, this husband. And you insult yourself. And you consider yourself as an adulterer. When you get married, you have a husband. But you let people call you whatever misses and you acknowledge that name. Then what kind of person do you think Jesus is? What kind of the Christ that you think you believe in, what kind of a man do you think he is? This is a very serious problem. But for the entire world, only we talk about this stuff. No one else in the world dares to speak about these matters. And this is reality. And the church is described as the body of Christ. The body and the head come together. You can't separate it. You can't call the head a name. And call the body another name. There's no such thing in this world. If you do that, people say you're crazy. And this is reality. It's very hard to hear. No one in the world addresses people like that. Usually, whatever the name of the head is, the body follows. Colossians
1:18.
Now, I copied this for everyone. Christ is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead. Jesus Christ is the head. All the saved people are the body. All saved people are in this body. This is found in Romans chapter 12. Verse 5. If you don't know, you can read it for yourself. Romans 12, verse 5. All the saved people are in this body. And that is in the church of Christ. The body always follows what the head is called. So the body can't have its own name. So the saved in the world are one body in Christ.
Continue.
So we being many are one body in Christ, and every one member one of another. So all the saved people in the world are in this one body. Their head is Christ. Their body is the body of Christ. The church of Christ. This is very important. For Jesus said, the saved are to be as perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect.
Now,
everyone should pay attention to this. Because Jesus said, you have to be perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect.
Matthew 5:48.
But everyone believes that no one can be perfect. And I understand how other churches explain this. Of course, Jesus said you have to be perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect. But there is a but. That Jesus has a great goal for us to chase after, a far-reaching
goal.
So that for our entire lives we can chase after this goal. To try our best to be as perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect. But we know we don't have the ability to be perfect. So that we can
be saved by grace.
Because we can't reach that goal, that's why we were saved by grace. And that's how they explain it. Some people even say, we don't have to read this verse. By the grace of God. If you explain it that way, you should go to hell.
没错, 根据圣经也都是这样说,
so according to the Bible, that's true, no one is perfect on this earth.
这个是罗马书3章23节,
this is found in Romans 3:23. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, no one's perfect.
所以呢,
and that's why everyone has to go to hell.
但所以耶稣说,
so that's why Jesus said you have to be perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect. So then how can we be perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect? By being in the body of Christ. Now I'm
going to
clearly share this again. You have to be in the Church of Christ. If you're in the Church of Christ, then you're in the body of Christ. Now it's clear. Today that you're in the Church of Christ, you have to thank God's grace. These wisdoms no other people have. Even for 1500 years they could not discover this. If we were in the body of Christ, then we're in the Father.
耶稣说,
Jesus said, the Father and I are one.
所以你在基督里面,
so if you're in Christ,
你就在父神里面,
then you're in the Father.
当我们在父神里面,
when we are in the Father, we are as perfect as the Father is perfect.
原来那条路是这样走吧,
and that's how you take that road, and that's how you walk that road.
是我们必须要,
that we must be and we are able to be perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect. Now listen carefully. Jesus said you have to be perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect. Then we must be able to be perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect. Jesus won't tell us to do something that we can't do. Jesus said you have to be perfect, then you should be able to be perfect. And you have to be as perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect. So Jesus' way or method is very easy. You have to find the Church of Christ. You have to believe in Jesus according to the Bible. You have to be baptized into the Church of Christ, into Christ. And then maintain staying in the Church of Christ. And then you can be in the Father. Once you're in the Father, then you're perfect as the Father is perfect. And there's only one way of explaining this. So don't listen to people when they say this is a far-reaching goal. This is something that we must do.
是我们能够做的事,
it's something that we are able to do.
感谢神的恩典,
by the grace of God.
就是这个, 就是这样, 这种的真理知识呢, 神只是给基督教的人,
so it is this way, and this knowledge has been given only to the people in the Church of Christ.
啊, Richard, you listen to me, okay? Don't talk to me. 这个真理知识呢,
so this knowledge, God only gives it to the people in the Church of Christ. And this is also according to the Bible. How come this has been preached for 1500 years and they still don't know? They have no ability to understand how to be perfect. They don't even have the wisdom to know how to get into the Church of Christ. And recently, I discovered a very sad thing. So Taiwan wants to go to China to follow China's laws.
They are what are we? Any Chinese taste in Taiwan, okay? Taiwan, so he wants to make it non-Chinese-ified, Taiwan independent.
So they want to be Taiwan wants to be totally independent, and they want to wipe away anything or any Chinese anything with Chinese.
Yeah, they want to wipe out anything has a connotation. Let people think about China. They want to wipe out anything can let people think about China. 现在我发现很悲惨,
this is very sad, I discovered this.
在这件事呢, 我发现美国这里, 从1965年开始,
so in America, starting from 1965,
America is a wipe out 有上帝的文化,
they wipe out anything to do with God.
特别是 Bible, culture, 啊, 走着这条路, wipe out.
So they're on a,
越来越少, 越来越少.
So they're on a path to wipe out anything to do with God. So there's less and less of these things.
你坐下小心想想就知道,
so when you sit down and you think carefully, you will know.
这个是现实的问题,
and this is reality.
圣经的教训呢, 越来越少, 越来越少, 越来越少.
The teachings of the Bible are less and less.
So if
you're not inside the Church of Christ,
慢慢你什么都没有了,
over time it'll all disappear. You won't have anything. Now the entire world is very successful.
啊, 我做个比喻给你看, 基督教的四个字,
so the Church of Christ, those words, how do you read them?
在英文里面没得说的,
you can't talk about this in the English, but in the Chinese, there's four words that represent the Church of Christ.
因为英文呢, Church of Christ, Church of Christ, 刚刚的了,
because in the English it's correct, it's just Church of Christ, but in the Chinese, so it's very sad over here at this point.
英文呢, accurate,
because the English is already accurate,
但是他又故意不要照做,
but they, on purpose, they don't do it. So they add one more sin to themselves.
啊, 但是我们中文呢, 你可以读基督教, 啊,
the
基督教,
Chinese,
a religion.
You can read a religion.
你这样读基督教, a religion.
If you just read the first three words, it means religion. Religion, a religious meaning.
但是呢, 我们圣经的教法, 基督教会, 是两个,
but, you should combine those two, the first two words with the second two words to mean Church of Christ. So when even in the Chinese, when they see the Church of Christ, those four words together, in their heads they think religious meeting. And it's very sad they can't be saved. Because what they think, what they see, and what they say, it's not together. So if I want to say it another way, they're crazy.
Yeah,
their mind is a mess. So this is a problem of reality. So Satan is very successful in this matter. So I can only give a very simple example. According to my life right here, right now, since I was in elementary school, all blackboards are black.
All chalkboards
are black.
Yeah, on the classroom, they're all black. 后来上中学的时候，开始变成绿色。
Then when I went to middle school, it started to become green.
因为我们发现对学生看见绿色的板呢，对眼睛有。
Because students looking at a green board, it's better for their eyes.
但我们一样叫绿色的板叫做黑板。
But even though it's a green board, we still call it a blackboard.
那我们叫白色的又叫做黑板。
So even if it's white, we still call it a blackboard. So we're already crazy. So you can say they're very successful. So even though our eyes see a white board, we still call it a blackboard. Although even though we see a green board, we still call it a blackboard. So you see green, but you say black. When it comes to the Church of Christ, it's also the same. They're very successful. They always say religious meeting. So that's why this morning I told them to practice a few times.
Yeah, and repeat after me.
So let's practice this a few times. So say those four words together, which means Church of Christ. So I believe that after they go home for a few days, they're gonna again in their minds think religious church or religious meeting. And the world can't be saved. Have you ever heard of anyone that can link up these scriptures this way? Number one, can they discover these verses? Number two, can they link it up this way? So God specifically provided this way for us, for the Church of Christ. No one else in the world can have this knowledge. And this is reality. Because God specifically stored this piece of wisdom for the Church of Christ. Now I'll remind everyone again. To learn this English word specified. So specified. It's a very important word. So God, when it comes to worship, God specified specifically what to do. So I'm going to give a very simple example. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 15. When it comes to praising God, you have to offer the sacrifice of praise. And what do you use to praise God?
就是那承认主名之人嘴唇的果子，所以我特别将佢underline。
That is the fruit of our lips, where I specifically underlined.
嘴唇的果子。
The fruit of our lips.
今朝早10点钟，我哋又有3个新嚟嘅。
This morning at 10 o'clock, we have 3 new people.
佢一嚟到有个唔习惯。
So once they came, there was one person who was not used to this.
就系呢度冇个钢琴。
He was not. He said that there's no piano there. You noticed there was no piano there.
我知道有个练习,
and I know.
所以我特别提呢样嘢,
so I specifically reminded them.
我哋敬拜神献赞美的祭,
when we worship God and we praise God,
神已经 specified 特意指定,
so God specifically specified.
看啦, 神已经特意指定,
so God specified. To use the fruit of our lips. And they always say, well, every church has a piano. And even today I passed by a church. I saw a big man holding a large piano.
And
the piano was almost as big as he was. And he walked into the church. Now, a lot of churches have a lot of instruments nowadays. But the Bible specified when it comes to praising God, you have to use the fruit of our lips. So a lot of churches use these instruments to demonstrate how much wealth they have.
你知唔知, 如果你買最好的小提琴, 一支多少錢啊, 幾百萬都有。
Do you know if you want to buy a very nice violin? Do you know how much that costs?
還有那些鋼琴啊, 幾十萬的都有。
And do you know those pianos, they could cost many thousand dollars or $50,000 or more.
但呢, 神規定, 特意指定嘴唇的果子。
But God specified to praise with the fruit of our lips.
如果你在教育的時候,
If you were in the Old Testament, Aaron's sons tried to worship God, offering things that were not specified, and they died immediately. Not to say I have a black heart. I hope that one day that God executes this thing. All the people who believe, all the religions that believe in God, when it comes to worship, if they do anything that God did not authorize or specify, that they die immediately. If one day this happens, there could be maybe billions of people, 1 billion people die immediately. When it comes to worshiping God, they didn't do what according to God, what God specified. And they would die immediately. It's very sad that this time has already passed. Now, there's no such matter of events happening nowadays. So that's why people in the world today, they worship God however they want. But 2,000 years ago, Aaron's two sons, they worshiped God this way, or the way they wanted, and they died immediately. So everyone in the world has to immediately pay attention. When it comes to worshiping God, God demands absolute obedience.
When
it comes to worshiping God, you can't do anything that He did not specify. And then this is what Moses said to Aaron. This is it that the Lord spoke, saying, I will be sanctified in them that come nigh me. And before all the people, I will be glorified. Then Aaron held his peace. Now listen carefully. When it comes to worshiping God, you have to be obedient. You have to be absolutely obedient. You cannot use anything that God did not specify. In the New Testament time, even if you can do all these things, you will say to the Lord, Lord, Lord. And you will preach in His name. You cast out demons in His name.
And
you've done many great works in His name. Even if you can do all these things, and you can raise the dead, but if you don't worship according to the Bible, so Jesus will say, I never knew you, you are evildoers, depart from me. So they'll preach in Jesus' name. They'll cast out demons in His name. They'll have done many good things, good great works. And they address Jesus as Lord, Lord. And what evil did they commit? In verse 21 it says, so once you read verse 21, then you will know why. And I'll read it. Jesus said, not everyone that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father, which is in heaven. So it's very clearly stated here. Even if you preach, you can do miracles, perform miracles. If you don't worship God according to the Bible, and you're offering something that God did not specify, I'm just saying one thing. On Sunday, when you come to worship God, you announce that we're starting our worship in the name of Jesus. And your piano, once you make a sound, then you should all die. You don't have to say anything else. Because God specified you have to use the fruit of your lips to praise Him. So once your violin makes a sound, then you all die. But so it's sad that these events don't occur today. So sometimes I always think, if God allow this thing to happen today, then when people would worship God today, once the instruments make a sound, then everyone die immediately. If that could occur for a few months, only that way will the people of the world stop using instruments. And during at the end of days, one day it will be like that. So in conclusion, why must I worship God in the Church of Christ? Because if you worship anywhere else, your worship is in vain. And that is the best conclusion. An even more serious conclusion would be Jesus would call you evildoer. If you want to ask me what evil are they committing, and my answer would be you have to ask Jesus. Because it's what Jesus said. So those people preached in His name, cast out demons in His name, did many mighty great works in His name. But Jesus called them evildoers. This is found in Matthew chapter 7, verses 21 to 23. Why must we worship God in the Church of Christ? Because this church was established by Jesus. Because this church is the virgin wife of Christ. Because this church is the body of Christ. Because you must be perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect. So you must be inside the Church of Christ. If you are not, then you cannot be perfect. Then you cannot be saved. So because we're saved, we need to be in the Church of Christ. And today I'm clearly sending this message, or preaching this message. I hope that everyone in the world can know this. May the Lord bless you and keep you.
Okay, now we're going to pray.